Swear to God, I'm not dead. Just been busy doing things and stuff. Let's start over. My Kinvians, and welcome to a brand new episode of Discovering Torchwood. Yes, finally. I feel like I've said that at the beginning of a lot of my videos recently. Way too many delays in between episodes. But today, the episode I'm going to be reacting to and reviewing is Combat, aka episode 11 of the first season slash series, whatever you prefer. And apparently, this episode was directed by... I'm forgetting his name now, but the guy that played Mickey in the first few seasons of Doctor Who, which is pretty awesome. So, let's get right into it and watch Combat, an episode that I've heard some kind of negative things about.
Outside the government, beyond the police. Tracking down alien life some on better. Earth and arming the human race against the future. The 21st century is when everything changes. And you've got to be ready.
Van Hose.
Have you done this to me?
Love, you're always at his mercy.
You barely even waved the steak under the grill and you said, why are you looking like that?
Sorry, like what?
Like you'd rather be someone else. You're speaking with an Normandy. You're just absent. What's happening to us, Gwen?
I know, I'm sorry.
Get more info on the relationship in this episode. Or... maybe more something she's done.
Down!
Don't ever speak to me like that.
Come on, Gwen. Let's go. Hey, it's you and me tonight. One night off, you promised.
If you go now, Gwen!
Ooh, I've got thoughts on this. Because... one,
sorry for cutting in, but I've been having a little trouble with this one.
Reese will get over it. He always does.
You promised to keep holding.
Oh, really?
Don't let it drift.
Anyway.
You can answer that. Ninth missed call.
Do pretty sure that's
there?
Illegal.
No, if you don't mind, I came out to be alone.
Ah, you'll regret a garble.
Sorry.
A bit of advice.
I don't want to answer my call. Why don't you silence it?
It's been even more erratic than usual since that thing with Diane.
Since the what?
It's none of my business.
Seriously, she didn't know.
What thing?
Oh my god.
What thing, Tosh?
You okay there?
Probably not.
We're looking for the people who were here last night. If you saw anything, now's a good time to speak up.
No, he's dead.
Jack, he's bleeding.
Bleeding and most likely dead.
You don't think I'd choose that ringtone?
Well, Jack, you never know. You might like Crazy Frog. Oh, okay, now we get to hear the great conversation between them two, these two.
The shittiest part about being a police officer, and I can't get away from it.
Oh, they actually didn't show it for once. That's weird.
Thanks for your kind words of support.
Oh, God.
What do you want me to say? She'll be all right in the end.
I mentioned you and Diane.
Oh, here it goes.
Did you?
I didn't want her to go. She went.
Why are we still doing this, Mew?
They're still doing it? Seriously.
Fine. Let's not. I'll get bored of your fuck tricks anyway.
You can be such a wanker sometimes, would you know that?
I do, as a matter of fact.
Okay, that was pretty funny. This guy is either going to be one of the henchmen or probably the main bad guy. He has that very, I'm far too pretty to not be involved, look about him.
They couldn't get any more out of him. At least it's one option. Okay, Janet, time for a trip out.
Janet?
You call it Janet?
Barbara just never seemed right.
Yonto's reaction pretty much mimics my how I would react.
What's your outlet?
For what?
The anger.
Who said I was angry?
Oh my god.
You're not even living here yet and you got people coming after you.
Yeah, well. Some people need teaching a lesson.
I'm not criticizing. You're not the only pissed off bloke out there. It's what the world does to us. Fancy a beer?
Yeah, why not?
You work yourself stupid.
Oh my god.
Phasm screen, or you end up with a workforce. People there specifically to look after you everywhere. Nothing.
Fight Club. They're using the plot or parts of the plot for Fight Club.
I don't live without all this. It doesn't define me.
Yeah. Nice to have you though, yeah.
Ask yourself. It's closer than you think.
I am the villain.
Out there, in the darkness, something is coming.
Where have I heard that? Well, good for her.
Then what are you telling me?
Because I'm ashamed, and I'm angry, and I need you to forgive me. And because I've drugged you.
You've done what?
Just sit down, it's nothing.
She gave him...
Just amnesia pill. Dasha said to have you wake up tomorrow and you forget it.
Seriously.
Please.
God, you selfish bitch!
I know. I just thought it would give us a chance. A chance to get everything out in the open. You know? Get everything out.
Well, I...
Please. Say you forgive me. Say it's all right, Gwen.
No!
Gwen, it's all right. Gwen, say it, please, Reese.
Had you not say drugged
it,
him...
Say it once, I forgive you. Reese, please, say it!
Seriously? You're going to pick it while he's within view and could easily look up and see what you're doing. Fight Club. With the weevil or weevils. Oh well. Close enough. Cage match with a weevil. He's suicidal.
Thank you.
Well then.
Has it been stolen?
Well then indeed. So, I am going to take a moment, jot down some notes, and I will be back with you all for the review. Hello all my Kinvians, and welcome to the review portion of Discovering Torchwood. We just finished watching combat, and even after taking the time to write down the notes, I'm still a bit flabbergasted, I guess you might say. But let's get right into it with my favorite parts of this episode. Starting with, I really like the fact that they modified the intro ever so slightly to include the little addition of Owen and Diane. Now, I don't recall other instances where the intro has been changed like that. I mean, other than, you know, the first episode to the other episodes afterward, but I really like that touch because it has just that quick little reminder of what's going on with Owen. Of course, to really get the full, I guess, sort of emotional impact of what's happening with Owen, you need to have watched the episode right before. But that's beside the point. My second favorite part about this episode was that we get deeper into, and also we get an escalation of Gwen and Reese's relationship. We get all kinds of just craziness in this episode. And up until a certain point that I will be talking about, it seems like they might actually be able to work through this. They'll be able to move forward from this. They'll be able to potentially recover their relationship, you know, especially when it came to the point where Gwen came out in the open about what happened. The way Reese was reacting made me think that he was so taken aback, but he loves her and he wants to work it out. Again, that's just my personal observation. Don't know whether that was the intention or not, but I really like the way this episode got into their relationship more. But moving on from there, my next favorite part of this episode was Owen at the bar, specifically more so the first time where he's at the bar. And again, I was talking about this near the end of the reaction, but I feel like Owen's whole reaction to the Diane leaving thing is a bit overdone. I mean, not to say that, you know, emotions can tear us apart, no doubt. It just, for some reason, coming from the show and Owen's character, it just feels off in some way. But at the same time, at the bar, he was a pretty badass, I have to say. Kind of put that one jerk into a Vulcan neck pinch, almost, or whatever it was. It didn't seem like he was actually hurting him in any way, or at least it didn't visibly look that way. But he took him down pretty soundly. And again, although being the brooding loner at the bar, there was just something about Owen in that scene that really worked for me. So yeah, I really like that. Moving on from there, my next favorite part about this episode, it was the crazy frog ringtone. And I know some of the people watching this are probably like, well, what in the world is Crazy Frog? Back in the early days of the internet, when things were just starting to really get popular and we had, I guess what you would say, the first version of memes, the Crazy Frog was one of the most hilarious things I had experienced at that point in my life. So just to sort of have that bit of a flashback, now given this episode came out after I'd already graduated from college, but all the same, it was still sort of in that window where, you know, I suppose I hadn't been too numbed by all the humor and all the things that are currently out there on the internet for us to watch. So yeah, I really like the fact that they had the crazy frog ringtone, and also that Jack said, "You don't think I would have that on my phone, do you?" Actually, I kind of think he would, for the right person. For the right person. But moving on from there, my next favorite part of this episode, again, just fairly simple, Janet the Weevil. I found just that little dialogue really funny, having to do with why Jack referred to her as Janet as opposed to Barbara. And then also Ianto's reaction to hearing Jack's logic. It very much reflects the way I would have reacted to such an explanation. Okay, so moving on from there, my next favorite part of this episode is Mark Lynch as a villain. As a villain, while extremely laid on thick, he had a good villain's presence about him. It would not be a villain that is very subtle. It is not a villain that you would really be looking to find anything deep hidden about them at all, but he portrayed the villain well. He did a good job. He had the right looks. He had the right expressions. He had that madness about him. So yeah, just Mark Lynch as a villain. I'll get to him more in a little bit, but as a villain, I really liked. My next favorite part of this episode is, and although it's me calling this a favorite feels strange, but I hope my explanation for it makes sense, but it's Gwen seemingly coming to terms with her actions. It's when she's at the at the hub by herself with the pizza, and she just breaks down. And in my mind, that is a moment of her realizing what she's done, how much she has screwed up so many things. Well, specifically with her and Reese, but I mean, you could say overall as a part of the group in general. I mean, with Owen, things are royally screwed up. With Tosh, I mean, God knows if they can actually be friends at this point. With Jack, she might be worried whether or not he can actually trust her. But yeah, but especially with Reese and what she did in the previous scenes, I feel like that scene portrayed her realizing and hopefully coming to terms with what she's done, which will hopefully mean we'll be able to move on from here, that things will be able to start to get better. Hopefully. But now, my eighth and final favorite part of this episode is Owen without fear. And it's part of it, you know, comes out as he definitely seems suicidal, which is not a good thing. But what Mark saw in him is like, you know, he had no fear. He went into that cage without fear. He was probably looking forward to dying without fear. You can't say that for sure, you know, but just on observation, that's the way it seemed. And walking up to Mark with the gun pointed straight at him, and again, it's like, you know, could have just been calling his bluff, could have been essentially taking his apparently newfound suicidal tendencies to the next level, but that was Owen without fear. And then we get the final scene where he actually terrifies the Weevils simply by snarling. And I'm gonna have more thoughts on that coming up, but just Owen without fear has some interesting possibilities for this show going forward. Again, at least from my perspective. Now moving on from there, my annoyances for this episode, and I realize that, as always, I realize some of these may just be nitpicks, but they are things that legitimately bothered me while watching. First of all, are we Gwen wasn't aware at all of Owen and Diane's fling. Really? I just don't know. I mean, it makes sense in a way that she was more preoccupied with the others as far as the people from the past. But at the same time, it seemed bizarre to me that she didn't have the slightest idea. Or I guess as she was saying to Tosh, what was it? I knew they had a thing, but not a thing. And first of all, that was poorly written, but also, really? Seriously? But that actually brings me to my next annoyance, which is Owen and Gwen's fight. The fight that happens in the car or the van, whatever. And I guess I was kind of blown away, and this goes back to my previous annoyance, but I thought they were done. Honestly, it's like after what happened a few episodes previous, and what was discussed with Tosh, I figured they were done. Apparently not. I guess they were still hooking up from time to time, but I don't know. It felt stupid and unnecessary and just annoying. It played into some of the elements of the episode, admittedly, but I don't know. I didn't care for it. My next annoyance with this episode is actually something I mentioned in the reaction, but when they're following Janet, they're not exactly leaving a lot of room behind Janet. So basically, if they are following Janet to wherever she might get kidnapped, people are going to see them, and the kidnappers will probably see them. Now, whether or not that might be a factor, I don't know, but if you're wanting them to take her and then follow without the tracker getting noticed, maybe not follow quite so close. I mean, yes, there is the worry that, you know, Janet could go off and start murdering people, admittedly, but at the same time, you're tracking her. That should have been all you needed to do, and then follow the tracker from there. And obviously it backfired, but at the same time, the guys probably noticed that the Weevil had been followed by, well, Torchwood, but the people who they didn't know. Anyway, so moving on from there, my next annoyance with this episode is Gwen. And I think a lot of that goes back to my first two annoyances, really, overall. But the biggest annoyance I had, and this is definitely a huge character flaw in here, and I hope that it's something that will be overwritten going forward because of what I perceived as her realization of what she's done. But she openly admits what she has done to Reese, and then reveals that she has drugged him. You know, I just don't know what to say about that. I mean, there was a lot I wanted to say about their relationship in general, pertaining to this episode, especially with that opening scene. But after that, it's really hard to see Gwen in a positive light. I'm hoping that will change for me going forward. But at the same time, after what she did in this episode, that's something that I don't know that I can forgive. It's like, you know, I may come to view her in a more positive light as time goes on. But that will always be there for me as a viewer. Reese, unless something happens to where he does remember, Reese won't remember the event, obviously, but as the viewer, obviously I'm going to. So that may be the biggest annoyance with this episode overall, or maybe just my biggest annoyance with Gwen as a character, because I've defended her a lot, and again, I'm hopeful as to what she is going to do moving forward. It's so hard to look past that with her as a character at this point. But maybe I'll change my mind. It's hard to say. But moving on from there, my next annoyance with this episode is Mark Lynch as a person. Now, you could kind of say that me saying this is sort of a commentary on the other guys in this fight club and others that kind of think like Mark, which there are people out there, admittedly, there are some people that you hear them talk about things enough. It's not an entirely inaccurate portrayal of some people, but as a person, just Mark is not a good person. And maybe I'm wrong in even calling this an annoyance. Maybe it's just an observation of personal prejudices against people with certain mindsets. I don't know. Maybe I'm getting a little bit too deep there, but Mark as a villain worked really, really well, but as a person, I'm just like, why would anyone interact with this horrible person? But again, without getting too psychological there, that could be said about a lot of people. But okay, my final annoyance with this episode, and it should come as no surprise at all, because I said it multiple times in the episode. Fight Club with Weevils. Really? Fight Club with Weevils. I can't believe they took that concept and, I mean, Fight Club, I don't think was technically the first ones to do sort of a plot like that, and wasn't the last. This will not be the last, but it's just so clear what they're doing. It reminded me of nothing else but Fight Club. And the message, the big social message they were trying to get across with that movie. Don't get me wrong, it's like the movie's really good. I love the movie. But trying to retell it in this show just doesn't work that well. Again, at least from my perspective, I feel like it fell flat, mostly because it was just a straight up mimic of the Fight Club message. Let's move on from there. As always, if you have any of your own favorites or annoyances for this episode, please do leave them in the comments down below, and I'd love to hear some of your thoughts about my favorites or annoyances. Just, you know, kind of see what you think of what I thought in that regard. But moving on, I do have a question for this episode. Actually, I'm going to hold off on the question because it's basically a theory, too. So I'm going to hold out until I get to my theory. So moving on from there, track of the episode, honestly couldn't really think of anything in particular. The only music that stood out to me were, as always, the Torchwood intro music, and then also the music that was playing at the end when Owen was in the basement alone with the Weevils. There was just something very suspenseful, very dramatic about it that really worked. So if I have a track of the episode, I guess that might be it. Whatever it might be called. But as for quote of the episode, or quotes, there was one that really stood out to me, and it's really... Now, as far as the relationship of Gwen and Reese goes, it's rather important, but don't let it drift, which is what Jack said. Really like that line, really found it to be... found it to be something that hopefully Gwen will work at as the show continues, and hopefully she'll take that to heart, or maybe, I mean, since she clearly has let it drift, maybe she will work to get it to drift the other way. I don't know. I feel like I was going to try and say that in a more more profound way. It just didn't quite happen. But yeah, don't let it drift. In my opinion, just a good overall quote from this episode. Now my second is a quote that reminded me of They Keep Killing Susie, and what Susie said near the end of the episode. It's when Mark says to Owen, "Somewhere in the darkness, something is coming." And I mean, in shows like Doctor Who and this one, I've come to find that usually something that sounds like it could be coincidence is not a coincidence. The manner in which Mark says that is a bit questionable, because while Susie has been dead and has seen the darkness and all that and sees that something is coming, Mark really only has like his deep insights into society, if you can call it that, to really pull from. So yeah, the quote itself really works, but the manner in which Mark came across that knowledge, to say it, is a bit questionable for me. But moving on from there, it's time for my theory. And again, this ties into what would have been my question. Well, the question that I had is, will Owen become a villain? And building off of that, my theory is, Owen is going to turn on the Torchwood team and kill himself, or try to kill himself while trying to take them down. Because unless he got over those suicidal tendencies at the end of this episode, it seems to me that he is still very much like, he feels like he has nothing left to live for, hence the lack of fear. So, while I don't have a good explanation as to why he would turn on the Torchwood team, other than maybe just being mad that Jack didn't let him die, that's just my theory. He's going to maybe become a villain, or at least do something to sabotage what's going on, which will result in him dying, or almost dying. It's hard to say, but yeah, that's my theory as to what could happen going forward. Now, as for my overall feelings on the episode, I want to like it. I really do. It was interesting, but it had way too many heavy negatives working against it. Again, although we get some great expansion as far as the relationship of Gwen and Reese. What Gwen does just really rubs me the wrong way. And then just, and again, this is just a personal thing for me, but it's impossible to not compare this episode to Fight Club in many ways. And that really bothers me, and it makes it feel like lazy writing. Like, basically, we're just like, okay, well, we need to do this with the relationship with Gwen and Reese to move on the plot. Then we also need to do something with Owen because he's heartbroken. And it's like, and again, I don't know if the guy that played Mickey wrote the script for this episode or if he directed it. I wasn't paying attention to the credits, unfortunately. But it feels feels lazy. It just, the use of that plot, the use of that overall message just feels lazy. But that's just me. And that's just my opinion. But that brings us to the end of this episode of Discovering Torchwood. Everyone, thank you so much for being here. And in addition to the favorites and annoyances, let me know any of your own favorite tracks, if there are any that stood out to you, some favorite quotes. Now, always with the theories and the questions, you know, if it might kind of be answered down the line, it's best just not to say anything. I am interested to see what you think of my theory. But again, as always, just try to keep it spoiler-free. And moving on from here, we'll be watching Captain Jack Harkness next time on Torchwood, because that's the name of the episode, Captain Jack Harkness. And I assume that in that episode, we will get a lot of Captain Jack Harkness. I feel like I kind of tripped over my words there. But until next time, everyone, I am Papa Ken, and as always, I hope you have a wonderful day, a wonderful night. Yes, I'm making this up as I go. But most importantly, Alonzi!